your passenger does not need to interject when you are the driver. It is not his responsibility. You are the one that I was conferring with.
I think sometimes I get a little shook up, so somebody speaks up for
me. Well, they don't need to.
Okay.
I was conversing with you. I wasn't being aggressive or anything like of that nature.
Okay.
Your passenger needs to learn to keep his mouth shut because he's not involved in the situation.
Now, I believe if you put that someplace and I don't give permission for it to be there, I believe that is a crime.
Got it. Yeah, got it. Hold up again. These motherfuckers are going to come back for us. Ready. You got to be prepared in this day and age. You got to be prepared for whatever the fuck comes at us.
Word up.
Because we are living revolutionarily.
Definitely.
You cannot second guess yourself in these days and times. They're going to throw whatever they can at you. And you got to be prepared for it. Prepared for anything.
Because of the controversial nature of the shooting and the questions surrounding it, KTVU decided to air the video. The video may be key in the case to help shed some light into what happened immediately before the officer fired his gun. But we also want to warn viewers, you may find the video disturbing to watch and may want to tell you.
Pain Road CCDC 1015, found one male.
One female en route to CCDC.
J1 and J3 en route to CCDC 2239.
En route to CCDC 1015 down 1 mil.
Now, I believe if you put that someplace and I don't give permission for it to be there, I believe that is a crime.
It's liberty for death. It's freedom for everybody or freedom for nobody.
Standing in front of the Carroll County Detention Center. CCDC is what they typically call it.
They say anything about my camera, I mean, they got lots of surveillance all around this place. So, it'd be hypocritical of them to say I can't film when they're filming us.
Now, I believe if you put that someplace and I don't give permission for it to be there, I believe that is a crime.
It's liberty or it's death. It's freedom for everybody or freedom for nobody.
That's what they charged. But I was just housed there myself a week ago, and it cost me $184 just to be released.
It seems like it's just a big money game.
Well, basically, I think it is. I think the booking fees are way outrageous. When you walk in there, just $25 just to be fingerprinted.
Ronnie Smith, running for Gallen County Sheriff on the Libertarian ticket. They didn't do the old phone book on the back with a flashlight, did they?
No.
No, they did that to a buddy of mine one time.
What did they do to a buddy of yours?
They put a phone book on his back and beat him with a flashlight handle.
Yeah.
And that way it doesn't leave any marks, just really blunt force, you know. Families near him, no one that knows him.
So
they have no problem beating the crap out of him.
Right. You think we need a jail here? For,
we do, of course.
For our own criminals?
Of course. It doesn't have to be a great big one either. It's not that many people here.
Right.
I believe that if they had one here in Gallatin County, it could keep down some of the expenses because they charge $30 a day to house Gallatin County in Carroll County.
Think your leaders care about you? Which one of these leaders are going to do something about the brutality that happens at the Carroll County Detention Center?
The brutality that happens in this jail is criminal. The way that the jailers act, and they're going to be surprised if anybody attacks them when they attack others. I don't think so.
Can we help you?
Yeah, absolutely. Who owns this jail?
Carroll County, Kentucky.
Who's the current jailer right now?
That'd be me.
Oh, you got anybody running against you?
No, I don't.
I had the unfortunate, accident or whatever of staying here.
Yeah.
And I didn't like the way I was treated. So I'm doing a story about the brutality that goes on in this jail.
Well, I'm going to ask you to leave the property.
Is it public property?
It's county-owned property.
So?
And I'm asking you to leave.
Right, but I'm allowed to be here.
I'm asking you to leave this property.
Right, okay. Well, that's good. That's good on camera. And I'm going to stay right here on the street and still carry on because it's public right. Now, frankly, I think I should be allowed to stay right here.
That's fine. You can go right out to the street, just like you said.
Okay.
No matter what the fuck life throws at me, I continue to make it through indefinitely. Immortal technique defeats the odds repetitively until the right shit ahead of me competitively. Surviving the tough times is imperative to me.
I don't know who William L. Wheeler is, but he shouldn't have his name associated with jailer brutality, which they say this is the Hall of Justice, but really it's the Hall of Injustice. This is the hall that allows for the jailer brutality to continue to happen continually. And you think when Gallatin County citizens come to Carroll County, you think they're going to treat us worse or better than they do their own citizens?
Looking at the whole world revolutionarily.
They don't want to hear you, old Uncle Tom, take us his head, talking about
technique will force you into strategic retreat because I dominate guerrilla warfare in the streets.
Well, okay. Kind of just shows you how it is. You know, they don't want anybody saying a word about what goes on in the jail.
You can say whatever you want. I'm just asking you to step off of the county property.
I ain't committing no crime.
I didn't say you was. Okay. At this point.
Okay.
All right.
Yep.
Now, I believe if you put that someplace and I don't give permission for it to be there, I believe that is a crime.
It's liberty for death. It's freedom for everybody or freedom for nobody.
Yeah, well, whoever the current jailer was, he just go ahead and try to grab my camera and try to turn nothing into something. Just standing out in the parking lot and just talking. Am I not allowed to talk in America? But it just goes to show you there is brutality here in the jail. The guy tried to take my camera. He tried to rob me. So that turned out to be true. They're allowed to record everything that we do, but if you turn the cameras back on them, they get infuriated. And you don't have freedom of speech here. Yeah, this place is fascist. I do not trust anybody in this building.
A 2-year veteran BART officer stands, draws his weapon, and fires.
Well, anyways, basically this is what society has for us. For young men, you can either look forward to going to the detention center, or go off to war and possibly not live.
There ain't no way to picture me without a victory speech. When I reach higher positions, without the recognition of pissed-on competition, because I conquered their renditions in a systematic form like a religious tradition. My mission is...
Think your leaders care about you? Which one of these leaders are going to do something about the brutality that happens at the Carroll County Detention Center? Eddie Mefford? Is he going to do something different? Jim Hamilton? Is he going to do something different? Daniel Mangiardo, you think he'll even come visit us? Bowling, you think he'll do anything? He's already part of the system. He probably tacitly endorses it.
Now, I believe if you put that someplace and I don't give permission for it to be there, I believe that is a crime.
It's liberty or death. It's freedom for everybody or freedom for nobody.